phototransduction in the rod cells of the retina. Phototransduction is a process through which photons are converted into electrical signals. This begins in the eye. When a ray of light hits the eye, it hits in a place towards the back called the retina. The retina consists of two types of photoreceptors called cones and rods. We are going to focus on the rod cells, which are specialized for night vision. A rod cell has three main regions, an outer segment, an inner segment, and a synaptic region. The outer segment is composed of these discs, which contain the photopigment rhodopsin. Here we have the outer segment of a rod cell. Rhodopsin consists mainly of opsin and 11-cis retinal. Phototransduction occurs when light enters the eye and activates the opsin. This causes the 11-cis retinal to change all trans retinal, which in return also causes the opsin to alter its shape. The light also activates a G protein called transducin, which in its inactive state is bound to GDP. After becoming activated, it is able to exchange GDP for GTP. Then, the GTP bound alpha unit of transducin activates phosphodiesterase, or PDE. Again, rhodopsin is shown in purple and PDE in pink. The GTP-bound alpha subunit of transducin has just activated PDE. PDE hydrolyzes cyclic GMP, which lowers the concentration of cyclic GMP in the outer segment. This also causes GMP concentrations to increase. The sodium channels then close. In the dark, the sodium ion channels are open and the inward flow of sodium and calcium ions depolarize the cell. The positively charged potassium ions flow out through potassium channels, which has a negative or hyperpolarizing effect. However, when combined, the depolarizing inward flow and the hyperpolarizing outward flow lead to the depolarization of the photoreceptors. The phototransduction cascade begins to come to an end when activated rhodopsin is phosphorylized by rhodopsin kinase and ADP. This allows the protein arrestin to bind to the rhodopsin and inactivate the molecule. This inhibits the ability of rhodopsin to activate transducin. Without activated transducin, PDE also turns off. Guanylate cyclase is then activated and restores the levels of cyclic GMP and reopens the cyclic GMP gated channels. Sodium and calcium ions are then able to flow in again.